Oakdale is has a 4K through 5 choice program. We are a part of what I would say a 4K through 12 continuum. We have a STEAM program at the elementary level. The majority of our students feed into Saluda Trail Middle School, which is also a STEAM program. And then those students, the majority of them, feed into South Point High School, which came on as a STEAM program about 2 years ago.
STEAM stands for, the letters stand for science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics. But what it means is not those separate entities, but an integration of different, of all of those into one. And so what it means for them is taking real life experiences, adding in those elements of scientific method and integrating technology and engineering through the process and including some arts and calculations and mathematics. But it's not a separate entity, it's an integration of all those things in order to take it and apply it both now into what they're learning, but also into real life to extend beyond the classroom walls.
When they're building buildings, they have to think, is it stable on the base? Did someone shake the ground?
We use a process, the engineering design process. For this particular project, we started out with our question, and then we led us into, they created their invention, they brainstormed, they went through their plan, and so now they're in the building create. So they're in a Tinkercad program, which is a 3D program online, and they are able to build and design and create using those elements. And from there, we're going to take it and actually print it out into a product.
I'm creating a robot, and my robot, I haven't came up with a name for it yet, but my robot is supposed to be easy to control, easy to talk to, and easy to keep calm.
I'm working on a teddy bear that you can put a phone inside of, and you can message your family with the phone. You can like help with your homework and stuff. And it's also good to cuddle with. If you take the phone out, you can actually sleep with it.
I'm working on making a mechanical door that can open by itself. If people are holding a bunch of stuff in their hands and they can't open the door, then it could be like voice activated and they could just say open and it would open.
I was trying to make this electrical bed, but it's not looking good. Not everything works out the way you want it to. That's something I learned.
If I teach them to address it, well, if it doesn't work, that's okay. We talk about fail, the letters in fail, meaning first attempt in learning. So that was just my first attempt, so it didn't work. Okay, well, let's go back and let's see where in that process I need to redo, look at my plan, think about how I can fix that. That STEAM right there, you just redid your process right there. So I said reiterate that a lot so the students know that just because something doesn't work does not mean it. You failed.
Best part of STEAM class for me is just being able to create anything you want with no restrictions. It helps you learn more about it because they actually let you do it instead of the teachers just telling you how to do it.
I think giving them a foundation of learning how to build things, being able to persist, that your first design is not always going to work out, something might fall down, how do I keep going from there? I think those things are still going to be around, you know, in 20 years. I don't know what kind of, you know, jobs they're going to be, but I feel like if we give them a good foundation from the start, they're going to be able to do anything that they want to do. And that creative side, like, we really need to foster that while they're young and they still want to come to school and they love everything that we do.
STEAM just answers that question of why am I learning this? Why am I doing this? So problem solving is applicable regardless of your profession. Creativity, design, being able to collaborate and work with others is applicable regardless of what you choose. So I truly believe that regardless of the career choices for our kids, and really STEAM is in everything, so I think that they will be ready for whatever they choose as far as future careers. Oakdale is a Title I school, and we're about 67% African American, about 26% Caucasian, and then other. So when we talk about STEAM learning, oftentimes they talk about underrepresented groups, and our population of students, we want them to really see the possibilities in terms of what they can do for the future. So, you know, our future is the success of our students. So what are our students able to do? What are they able to say? How do people, when they see Oakdale students, do they notice something different about them? That's what I want to hear and say is that, you know, wow, these kids are thinking beyond, they're wanting to contribute. So I think for me, that would be the, you know, the future and the success for Oakdale would be the success for our students and the impact that they have beyond Oakdale.